On the Health Watch tonight, the FDA has approved the first drug intended to prevent HIV infection. It's called Truvada, and it is raising plenty of interest with doctors, patients, and AIDS activists here on the Central Coast. Action News reporter Phil Gomez joins us with a closer look. Phil?
Well, Erin, health professionals aren't calling it a cure-all. They're just saying that it's another tool in their toolkit in the prevention of HIV infections. Every year, 50,000 young people and adults contract the HIV virus. This new development could curb the spread of HIV in this country. It's estimated 1.2 million Americans have HIV, and researchers have long sought to create a pill that could help stem the epidemic.
I mean, I think the fact that we're making steady progress at the treatment of HIV and the prevention of HIV is a wonderful thing, and this is certainly a step in the right direction. You know, they haven't had much success on vaccines, although I know that progress is moving forward also. But this is definitely a way for people to protect themselves, although it's absolutely not 100% protection.
Public health officials believe that Truvada represents a major breakthrough, both as a medical treatment and as a means of expanding other preventative measures. The drug was approved for people who test negative for HIV infection. Allison Hayes, who's with Santa Cruz County HIV Testing and Prevention Program, says it's supposed to be used in combination with safe sex practices.
Something that within our toolkit of things to help prevent the spread of HIV, it's another potential option for us. Just like safer sex practices, just like regular HIV testing, for somebody who's at extreme high risk for HIV, taking this as a preventative measure in addition with those other precautions will really lower their risk of transmission.
There are side effects with Truvada. The most common include diarrhea, nausea, abdominal pain, headache, and weight loss. In rare cases, the drug may cause kidney problems or bone loss. Erin?
All right, Phil. Thank you. There's another issue with this new drug as well. It's expensive. Health experts say that it can run anywhere from $11,000 to $14,000 a year. And at this point, health experts say they don't know how many insurance carriers will actually pay for it.